Opinions expressed are that of the Sunday Funday podcast, John Bocanegra, Amber Edwards, Curtis Spivey, Dom Lawrence, or any guest host, or bystander at the time of recording. Any opinions stated do not reflect that of any entity or outside association to the personalities in or associated with the Sunday Funday podcast. Enjoy the show.
What was that? You can say that again. Everyone, welcome. You're already joining in on the fun, the Sunday Funday podcast. I'm your host, John Bocanegra, along with a very special collective group of guests. Go ahead and introduce yourselves.
I am John Ryan Gallegos.
I'm Brie. What's up?
Hello, I'm Kinsey.
And I'm the emo vegetable.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Why?
Oh, my God.
You have to explain that. Okay, if you don't know, and you probably don't, because I didn't introduce them at all. They're with the Artication podcast, which is something, I guess it's a side project of sorts, one of many that I'm doing, because I'm stretching myself thin, and I'm trying to keep myself busy. But, yeah, go ahead and explain that.
A long, long time ago, before socks were made out of cotton, there was a great raptor attack. No, I'm just kidding. God. My friends here call me Veggie or Vegetable. I'm in trouble because my last name on Facebook is Veggie Head because I was a vegetarian for like 11 years. So it kind of stuck. And now
you were?
Came to the dark side.
And now you're not?
Yeah, because I live in West Texas.
Oh, okay.
Steak! And Jesus barbecue. Chicken and water burgers.
And Jesus chicken and water burgers.
And
huge thing.
Okay, so we're doing a very special edition of this too. This is kind of a collaboration for the... I don't have a name for my network yet. I'm trying to establish the network. I've mentioned this a couple of weeks ago and last week, actually, when me and my brother did the one-on-one thing. That was a very long hour and 50-minute podcast.
Goodness, I thought we were long.
No, it's like me, but there's another version of me. But he's like the PG version of me. I say shit and fuck a lot, so.
Oh. Beep it a beep, beep it a beep.
John has a twin, if y'all
didn't
know.
And then he doesn't
Wait,
drink
what?
Either. Well, he
Hold
drinks,
on.
But. What?
You have a twin?
Yeah.
No, you don't. Are you serious? You're the evil twin.
I think that one goes without saying.
That's too legit.
Anyway, going back to what I was talking about initially, we had the Ladies Night podcast, which was a huge success. It wasn't. I actually don't even know if we're going to do this yet. This is pre-recorded, by the way. The Ladies Night podcast is happening. Special friend Marissa is joining us. Amber's going to be the host of that. And unless you're already listening to this one before you listen to that one, then, well, you already know what happened. So
this
I spilled the beans. No, but since this is a, I mean, we're all young adults here. We've all been in serious relationships, push and pull, went through that portion of life. Some people, yep, this is what we're getting into today.
Some are in it.
Valentine's Day is coming up. This is kind of a special thing that I had planned for about 2 months now. I feel the same way about it. Trust me. It's a big thing for younger couples, I feel, that they, yeah, see, exactly. And I feel the same way about Christmas, too, actually.
Yeah.
I've talked about this before. Everybody that's listened to
Sorry.
They know exactly how I feel about Christmas. It's like, yeah, you should be caring about your family. You should be caring about the well-being of others. Anyway, what is that?
It's a picture.
Oh.
We just looked at a picture.
Adriana just
your
showed
twin.
A picture of me and my brother.
Y'all look almost the same.
We're
different.
I mean, it's not like we're twins or anything.
Anyways,
We digress.
Jeez.
But for those that, wow, this is very shocking for everybody. No, Valentine's Day, I think, is generated more towards either struggling couples, like midlife crisis kind of couples, or younger couples that think that this is the idea of love. And I don't think that it should be, and it's, God, it makes so much money anyway. I think it's the third highest earning holiday behind Christmas, Halloween, and then, I was going to say Thanksgiving. No one earns money then. Everyone just gets fat. No, this is the third largest in terms of bringing all this gross, all this money in. It's Valentine's Day, which I feel has gone too commercial. Valentine's Day has been commercial anyway.
Yep.
Valentine's Day too.
What is, no, okay. No, let me ask you this real quick.
Holiday.
What is it? What does it mean? What does Valentine's Day mean to you?
It's definitely, it's not, okay, not anymore.
You're surrounded by
women. Let me establish your character real quick. You're romantic.
It's hopeless romantic.
Your heart's bleeding all the time.
Always.
There's blood pumping through it and not oil.
I see Valentine's Day. I do like to get into Valentine's Day when I have,
a Valentine's, but
express your love and affection.
I
through the art of cards.
Feel that Valentine's Day is what is a women's holiday.
Not, is it? I feel the same way. I feel the same way.
It's not directed towards couples any really anymore. Does anyone?
How many commercials are generated towards men not to buy things? Hey, you need the perfect diamond for your wife. You need to go to Jared.
This is true.
Come on, elaborate. Come
on. Yeah, come on. It's a.
I'm all for it.
Oh, but it's definitely towards women. Does anyone know the original story of Valentine's?
It's like bloody.
Valentine's
Day? It's about death.
It has nothing to do. The original has nothing to do with really couples at all.
Now it's a hardcore. now it's a hardcore holiday. Right behind Halloween.
I'm not even sure on how Columbus Day it is now.
Oh,
but
hold on. That's a different thing.
That's a totally. When we celebrate it, we're taking that Monday off. No, go ahead.
It's true. It's definitely directed towards women. Like, and then as males, it's like we're, not always, but expected to do something.
You're pretty much obligated to.
Yeah. And I feel like that's a lot of pressure on couples in general. It's like Valentine's Day, and no, like for
wait, couples, hold on, pressure on which couples? There are some couples.
Yeah, that's what I was like. If they're barely starting out, let's say like. I've been going out for like a few weeks. And then
for a good
day comes
7 months.
Yeah, for oh my god,
it's
like
a 2 month anniversary.
That's a lot of pressure on the dude because he's like, oh, I gotta get.
I've been in a relationship like that once. You know how long it lasted? 2 month anniversary. That's how long it.
No,
lasted.
My very first relationship. That's how it was. I was not into. I'm not a very Valentine's Day person. I'm just like, I'm cool with just chilling and watch TV or something like. And giving me some chicken nuggets. Like,
and this is why we have such a hard time finding.
You're what the men call an ideal.
See, hey, I am single, by the way.
we
get friend zone
so
all the
no,
time.
No, it's mostly because men, they won't say this, but they want the women to be the aggressor in most situations. It's like they don't feel like they should have to make the first move unless they get a cue to make the first move.
And I understand that because, I mean, I'm a very strong, independent woman. And
I've noticed, yes.
You know? And, but I do, I lifted the weights, but.
You just turned Romanian for a second?
I actually
have a friend
eagle.
That's Romanian. That's
No, but my first relationship, he was all like, he had pressure. I'm like, you don't have to get me anything. Let's just get food and chill. And he got me a huge teddy bear and chocolates. And
what
I'm
is
like,
what the hell is the point of a giant?
Now. She's like, oh my god.
That's so really. Okay, yeah, explain your side of this.
Okay. So I'm torn here because I've always wanted to get like one of those big teddy bears from somebody. I don't care who it's from. I just
see, look,
it'd be adorable. But I mean, if I got it from a guy, that would
five.
Be cool too. But also, if someone wanted to just buy me Chick-fil-A for Valentine's Day, I'd be totally.
What about
cool
a Chick-fil-A gift card? That would be way better.
Oh my god! Because
it won't only be for just one day. It'll be for however long you have the budget in that Chick-fil-A card.
Exactly. Well, I'm
if
not.
$5.
And I'm not the jewelry person either. Like, if someone were to give me, like, really expensive diamond earrings, like, I'm not going to wear that. I'm in the studio. I'm
okay, we have
that.
A jewelry expert here.
Oh, me? Oh, no.
I mean, if it was, like, made here in the studio.
Have you ever done that? Like, super sweet, like, just made the jewelry?
I definitely
like, that
have,
would be super
sure.
Adorable, and I would.
But the reason why I think Valentine's Day, like, I mean, it has its place, and it's nice, whatever.
It's
but
not.
I feel like it's kind of BS because people like flex their guns. But if you're going to be a romantic just one day of the year, then like, what the hell?
My thing.
That's
is
what I was saying about Christmas too. Like, if you're only going to take one time of the year to care about humanity as a whole, mm-hmm. Yeah, what's the point? Like, oh, we're only going to put this red kettle out when people trying mm-hmm. to guilt people into putting their money into this. I've went on about this before, but. Why should love be celebrated on only one day of the year? Unless you're married, because then you have your your anniversary. It's a totally different thing, though. Mm-hmm. No one in here is married, though.
No.
Correct?
Nope.
Oh, okay, so we're not talking about that side of it.
See, I don't know.
No, go ahead.
You find out who's also, like, materialistic. Because, like, some people are whatever side, man, woman, of the relationship, like, no, you don't got to get anything for me for Valentine's Day. Well, when they actually don't.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that yeah, people have
it's,
an issue.
And then that goes into, like, all the girl code stuff that's total bull. Because it's, like,
at least for my me, it's like, if I tell you, I really don't want anything, I don't want anything. Yeah, but some other girls are like, oh, you don't have to get me anything. And then they tell their girlfriends, he didn't give me shit. Like,
no, see, yeah, okay, what's no. what's the over-under on when you should actually, when would be the comfortable time to get gifts?
It's going to depend from person to person.
Yeah.
No, okay, let's say on average. We're throwing everything out. This is in a vacuum. This is where this takes place.
I think, I don't know, I think, you know, once you've been dating for a while. Like,
what's a while to you?
I think a good period of time.
I'm asking everybody this.
Once you start to get to know somebody is after 3 months, so you're looking at 6 months.
Yep.
That's reasonable.
Yeah, because I feel like that's half of a year. You've spent a good amount of time together. You know each other fairly well.
Mm-hmm.
Once you hit 6 months, you know whether this is something that you want to be in or not in.
Yep.
So, what's a reasonable amount of time?
To give gifts or just to...
Well, wait, what constitutes as a gift? Like, is giving it up counted as a gift?
Oh, that is a gift. Hold on. That is a gift in its whole...
Is it? Whoa, hold up.
Whoa, yeah. Wait, dude, I was watching a TV show last night, and about every other episode, they would explain that they love each other, and for the first time, they'd say,
I love you, let's bang.
And sex.
Oh, yeah.
No, that's not how that works.
Wait, what show was it?
This was Chronicles of Shannara.
Ooh, that's a good one. Yeah. But yes, I know.
Well, today's society is so lustful. Like, sex has, like, has
there's
lost
a difference.
Its
everyone
love
knows the
now,
difference.
Yeah. For sure. I mean, that's why.
The society, I think, kind of like, it shows it in TV shows and stuff. Like, after, like, the first date, like, the. Or, well, like, yeah.
You could also
stands.
Blame the FCC for that, because in the last 15 years alone, you've been able to get away with a lot of stuff.
Well, that's
nowadays,
right.
All what you're exposed to is what's going to affect you.
And I fear for, like, people, like, younger kids that are growing up.
13-year-olds
like,
getting pregnant right
exactly.
now. Exactly.
That's what I mean.
But that's also been happening before the advent of television,
definitely.
Though.
Oh, yeah, but
definitely.
Still.
But it's on the rise, and that's, like,
actually, it's on the decline. STDs with people under 18 years old has decreased by,
well,
like,
good.
30%.
At least we're doing something.
At least
right.
You know
protecting
what age group has the highest STD rate?
16 and above.
Yeah,
16
and above. They don't care. They're like, I don't give a shit.
I'm gonna die in like 2 years. It's fine.
No. I don't know. It's like, for me, I think, you know, the exposure and what's seen, like, which doesn't hold as much weight anymore in TV shows with pornography and all that stuff, really does affect.
Everything's so easily accessible too.
All of us. Yeah, no, with the internet, it makes everything
Mom won't
very
tell
accessible.
Me this, but I can look it up.
Yeah, but
quick.
I can freaking Google it. It's like, I don't know what this is, but
Google.
I can freaking Google it if I want
Google's
to.
Google's the teacher.
Shout out to Google.
No, yeah. Shout out to Google. But no, I think it's ridiculous. For me.
Actually, yeah, shout out to Google for Google Play Music, which you can find us on show free and Artication as well.
Woo!
I'll get into that later. Go ahead.
But no, like, okay, so for me, I am not.
Let's sound it out.
Use your words.
Hold that thought. So how long is, like, the relationship?
Yeah.
Is the relationship, like, please, when do you start? Surely you've purchased a gift for somebody before.
I make gifts for people because I'm poor. So, and
okay,
being a jewelry
does that
maker,
go? Does that go? I think that goes a long way more than buying
more.
A gift. Yeah, that's more sentimental.
Yeah.
And I think it's not a holiday. This holiday is more about sentimental value and about connecting with the significant other that you have.
Right. If I've been dating like a guy, I'm not, but if I'm dating a guy for like, let's say right now it's been like a year. Then yeah, I'll make him something. But like, if we've only seen each other for like a little bit, I'm not gonna.
What's a little
make
bit?
Anything like maybe
2 weeks?
Two weeks to three months or something.
27 weeks.
Like, I think, like what Taylor was saying, like 6 months. Like yeah, like you know, and it depends on the type of present too. Like if it's a teddy bear, it's like, oh, that's so generic now.
What a waste of money.
I think it is a waste of money.
But they're very good cuddly buddies. I'm just saying.
Yeah, so that when he breaks up.
So are throw pillows.
Months. Yeah.
But it's like a pillow in the shape of a bear.
I don't know. When it hits 6 months for me, I'm not expecting a gift or anything. For me, it's like, if I got a card on Valentine's Day, that's awesome.
If you give me a flower,
that's
perfect.
Whoa. That's like incredible. That means the most to me. I am laminating that thing. It's going in my card box. Like
it does. It just means, I mean, I guess it does depend on the type of person you're dating too.
Because
if they're like, so I've been with guy like my first boyfriend, he would buy me presents all the time. I'm like, what are you doing? And then I felt obligated to get him something. And
that's
just that pressure.
Exactly how I operate. And she knows how I operate. Okay, she got me this Fitbit for Valentine's Day. It tracks all the movement and everything, which is good because I like analytics and I'm all trying to be
nerd.
You've seen me play. Like, yeah. I'm all over the place. So.
He'll stop the middle game and check his steps.
Actually, it's not on my wrist, so it's in my drawstring on the.
Oh my
so
god! Like, oh, hang on. Stop in the middle of the game. Let me check my. Yeah.
Sometimes it's hard to get out because it wraps around my junk, so I'm just like, oh, no, I'll just check it later.
Other people are like, is he checking his junk in the middle of the game?
I'm just on the bench, just and John Ryan's like, hey, what are you doing? Checking it.
Checking my fit.
It'd be worse if I was like, hey, I need you to check this real quick.
It's like tying my shoes.
Checking my Fitbit. Is that what they're calling it these days?
Yeah, checking the old Fitbit. You seem to be on the opposite side of the fence on this issue.
Okay, well, my parents actually struggle with this issue because my dad is like the real emotional person in the relationship, and he's always the one getting like these really sweet cards and these crazy aww gifts. And my mom was like, today's Valentine's Day. Oops. And she doesn't. She never knows what to get my dad. So I'm kind of in between. I'm kind of like my mom and kind of like my dad, where I like sentimental things.
I think we all are. Yes, that's yeah. How the
but
how that works. Yeah,
but
that's
I'm
how
also cool with just like if you buy me a pizza and we watch Netflix for Valentine's
Netflix
Day, I'd be really cool with that.
For me, it's like it's not the freaking gift. It's like
it's the idea behind it.
Yeah, it's the
like
thought.
If I'm freaking working or something, and my boyfriend at the time comes in, and he just goes, hey, how are you doing? I just wanted to come say hi.
That's awesome.
Or like, oh, I'm so slammed at work right now, and he brings you dinner.
Yeah, that makes me happy as hell. Cute. Like, that's what I would
they're
bae
for life. They bring me food? Ha!
Like, I'm not...
Hold up, that just negates every other character flaw about the person.
No.
Like, no, he brought me food. It's all good.
No. I'm like, I am so torn when it comes to stuff like this, because I'm a very, very emotional, very sentimental person. I am a huge romantic, but I'm also a freaking huge goddamn cynic.
A realist.
Yeah. Exactly. I'm a realist. There's no such thing as Prince Charming. What makes a good marriage and what makes a good relationship is freaking communication.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And work.
Yep.
I
think we're all old enough to actually know. And that's the idea behind this, too, is that everything is romanticized. Everything's fantastical. There's happily ever after. And that's just generated towards the people that are just getting into stuff like this.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I feel like kids don't understand. I say kids. I'm meaning like 21 and under. Like,
oh, yeah.
I mean, kids.
Am I the oldest person in the room?
Well, like, how old are you?
I'm 27.
Yeah.
I guess. I'm next. I'm 24.
I'm after him.
24? Oh, my God.
I'm 23.
Dude, I'm 21.
Anyway.
So you're a kid.
So you're a kid.
I'm the baby.
Yeah, you're a baby. Oh, so everything's still bright and shiny to you, then.
It's Brie, the feeling.
So you and I think there's the always Valentine's Day aisle.
I mean, it's bright. Like, it's bright. It's inviting. It's soft. It's
full of pink.
It's kind of depressing because I've always been single on Valentine's Day. I've either, like, broken up with that person before
right now,
or... No, I'm all.
No, you got me.
Oh,
and Katie.
That's right. I mean, I have my girlfriends and stuff, but like, I haven't been in a serious relationship on Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
What's y'all's longest relationship?
Oh, God.
Or any of my relationships?
Nick, I think.
4 years.
4 years.
In my adult life.
Like 9 months.
Wait, do we have to do adult life?
Like after 20.
After 20. Anything before that doesn't. Well, high school, I guess.
Yeah, like.
So high school and up.
Because I had my like first boyfriend like 16. And that's the one who would, like, buy me all the gifts and stuff. And
yeah.
I'm like, woo.
See, my longest relationship was from, like, middle school to high school. It was 4 years.
Whoa. I was not allowed to have somebody in middle school.
My brother was in a relationship for 7 years before he got married. And he met his girlfriend our junior year, 2006. They've been married for 3 years now, as of this year. Everyone's glowing with excitement over here.
Sorry. No.
Our friend Emily.
Woohoo!
We're not at my house, by the way. Like, normally we do this podcast in around my coffee table. We're actually, where are we at?
Art 3D Annex on Texas Tech campus, where we have our jewelry studios, ceramic studios, sculpture, metal studios. So
we're on location.
We're on location right now.
Yeah.
But this is where Artication actually does their show.
Yes.
I'm showing everybody, like, they can see me, they can't. It's a nice facility. It's giant. This place is massive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm a bit...
Just in the world.
Like, on topic, I'm a bit of a... I'm a giver, for sure. And
depends on what we're talking about.
Well, when it comes to, like, relationships or with anyone, I consider myself a giver.
In the
sense
way.
Where I just, like... I get more out of giving someone something than getting something
Dude,
from someone.
Same, but it f***s me every time.
So...
Right in
and
the butt.
It wasn't requested.
Well, it's the same with me. Like, I'd rather give them something, and like, if somebody gives me something, I'm gonna go, ugh.
My thing is, but, like, if someone gets me, and I'm like this with Christmas also, damn. It's someone gives me something, and I feel like I have to return the favor because I feel not obligated to, but I feel like this person is doing this for me, and they're putting this, and it sucks that people put a price on things, and that's kind of how it goes with Christmas and Valentine's Day in particular.
That's why I make everything, man.
Yeah, same. I make things.
Another thing where communication, at least for me, comes in, because you can talk about that. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't. It like in one ear, out the other with her. Like, yeah. I tell her exactly what I don't want. Mm-hmm. I tell her that I don't want anything, and then I end up getting a Fitbit for Valentine's Day.
But I mean, she knows you. She's got it.
Yeah.
Adri's awesome.
Yeah,
though.
She's. And I mean,
it is awesome. I'm not saying that I don't appreciate it. She knows that I do.
Oh yeah.
And I tell her every day that I love her. But it's just stop. it's like I said. It's putting a price on these things, and it feels like it's so commercial, and it feels like. What's the real reasoning behind this? Like, are you doing this because this day tells you to on the calendar, or are you doing this because you actually feel this
way? And I think that goes into the type of gift if you do give gifts, because there's some relationships where just like, here, I got you this, like, millionaires, let's say.
They're like, oh, another Valentine's Day. Here's this diamond necklace.
Here's this diamond that's worth a zillion dollars.
Here's this extinct animal.
There's
that's what I would do if I was rich.
Right? Like, here's a jaguar.
Here's bees. Bees are going extinct, by the way.
Yeah, don't bring it up.
No, Bree's sad. No, but like, it goes into all the thing. Like, there's either people who would get showered with gifts, and other people are like, "You're so lucky," and then that person's just like, "He's not putting or she's not putting any, you know, emotion to it." Where it's like me, I make my stuff because I want to take that time because I care about those people.
Time is the most valuable asset.
Yeah, and you can't get it back. You can only give it.
No,
you know,
see, for me, like. And I've been in a relationship where he'd ask me to come over and I'd come over and we'd hang out. But his form of hanging out was him playing League of Legends and me sitting there so bored on his bed, I'd fall asleep. Yeah. Okay, I'm about video games.
I'm sorry I do this. Me and my brother play Battlefield. Like, that's how everybody knows
this.
Yeah,
but this is the I want to hang out. We haven't spent time together. Let's hang out.
That's different.
That's some bull. And I mean, I'm all in for... like watching movies and playing video games and stuff, but it's like when I'm falling the f*** asleep on your bed and you wanted me to come over and hang out with you.
That's
are
a
you
sign.
Freaking kidding me?
It's also a waste of time, which again is the most valuable commodity.
Oh, it's a waste of time. Yeah.
It's like, can you pause on the game and like, let's.
Like the game's not going anywhere. I've learned this growing up. It's like the game's not going anywhere. The lady's not always gonna be there. That's the thing. It's like you need to find time to. It's mostly about prioritizing when you get older, too. Yeah. It's like, there's all these things I need to do, but I need to find what's most important and then put my effort into that time.
And at that point, I didn't feel prioritized at all. I felt like you didn't care at all, and I broke up with him.
And then I think Valentine's Day is like kind of a cheap out if you, like, say you are on a rocky road, and it's like, oh, man, what can I do to make this up to her? That's why people buy flowers. Mm-hmm. That's why men buy flowers. Because they're like, they're always, all the time, I'm f***ing up right now. Hey, here are these roses. Like, that's going to make everything better. That's just like putting a band-aid on a wound. Especially, well, it depends on the problem in the relationship in the first place. Right. Like, not listening or not spending time with somebody. It feels like a cheap out, I think.
See, that's why it's like, just talk. When did it become such a big deal that we're supposed to not talk to each other about things? Like, the same thing with, like, women faking orgasms. When did that become... You should talk.
It's great to hear, but it's terrible to experience.
Exactly. I need to tell... Yeah, every sexual partner I've had, basically, it's been a fake. So, it's so unfortunate, but you know what? It's one of those things where it gets to the point where it's like, fake it till you make it, because this is getting ridiculous.
It's making them happy. You can deal with it by
yourself. You can laugh, by the way. Like, you can talk in outbursts. Like, just because we're in front of the mic doesn't mean you can't either, so you're good.
And that goes right back to communication. Emily. That goes right back to trust, and that goes right back to me being a people person.
And this is... Okay, who likes Disney movies?
Me?
Okay, you're all idiots.
Yeah, it's like all of us.
They tell you this. Like, hey, you find your Prince Charming, or hey, you grow legs and you can walk on land. But
no, you don't. She turned into a bunch of sea foam.
Here's the thing that happens is they don't show you the adversity. They don't show you the trials and tribulations of relationships. Mm-hmm. And everyone thinks that these things are attainable because... They showed me that this is, going back to the media thing. Like, this is how it happens.
After 2 days, we're in love. Let's make a baby. It's like, hold on. Whoa.
Like, I just got my legs. I don't even know how everything else down there works.
Yeah, but we're doing it. It's fine.
That's a Little Mermaid reference, by the way.
Quote unquote love. And I think that's like so loosely used too, is the word love.
No, I don't just throw it around all willy nilly.
Well, I mean, it depends, like in a relationship, like just like, oh, you love them, so you must do sexual things with that person. Like,
no, because John Ryan has a son. He loves
exactly.
his son.
Exactly. No, I mean, in relationship wise, like between, like romantically.
Uh huh.
And like in media, like so, you love them, so you must do this, this, and this. Like they, you have feel obligated. You love them, so you have to do this, this, and this.
See, when right. I have sex with somebody, I have to have an emotional connection with them, and I have to.
I think that goes for everybody, even if it's just on the lust level. You have to have some sort of connection with the
I
person.
I don't know.
Whether it's attraction, whether it's like, yeah. hey, I like the way she laughs or whatever.
See, yeah, the attraction
is still a connection.
No. Yeah, the attraction yeah. thing. But there are people, I mean, like, Tinder is a great example of this where it's like,
no.
hit it or quit it. It's a hit it or quit it.
We've talked about this before, so you're yeah. not going into uncharted this waters.
No, but yeah, I mean, there are guys that I was talking to, like, another guy. I was talking to a guy the other day, and he was like, okay, so age, sex, location. I was like, well, my Tinder profile gives you
people
all that
still
anyways.
Ask ASL?
Yeah, he did. And I was like, so what the hell? Do you mean American Sign Language? And he said, no. He said, I mean age, sex, location. I said, well, one, my Tinder profile gives you all that. And he goes, yeah, well, I figured an AIM thing was better than, hey, you want to bang? And I said, yeah, there it is right there. Hit it and quit it. Yeah.
Well, then he would just, like, done delete conversation.
Yeah, basically.
Like... so who... John, with y'all's relationship, who said I love you first?
Ooh. Oh, okay. This is interesting.
Hey, oh, hey.
She did. Here's what happened.
Oh, okay. Story time.
We're laying
story
down.
Time.
We're already telling stories.
Thank you.
Story time. Y'all a little late to story time.
Oh.
She said I love you. And I said, no, I said, what? Why? That's exactly what I said. No, this is because, okay, my thing is, and people that have heard, y'all haven't heard this, so this is new to you. I came out of a relationship that was with somebody that was supremely insecure. She was a model, but for some reason she found things to pick at and analyze and overanalyze and magnify, and it turned into something that was not anything I wanted to be a part of, and she was, how do I put this delicately, trying to kill herself at the time. So it was, yeah, that
she was
delicate.
A drama queen.
Yeah, pretty much. Actresses are, models are.
I'm allowed to say that she's a drama queen because I've had suicidal tendencies. Okay. Anybody else? No.
Did you actually try it?
Yes.
Oh, okay. She did.
I'm allowed to say it. She's being a drama queen.
But this happened before she met me, and then she was kind of struggling with it around the time that we actually started getting together, talking and being in a relationship, not getting together. But you can laugh at that. That's fine. But I was dealing with stuff. Okay. I was dealing with stuff that was from that relationship prior to that one. So right. mm-hmm. two people before Adriana was something that I was dealing. And she knows all about this, and everybody does, I think, except y'all. And now you do. So it was just a whole bunch of things. I was dealing with beforehand, and I was kind of. I mean, she was practically at my house all the time. So it's easier to connect to somebody when you're around them more. Mm-hmm. And that's why 2 weeks in a relationship like this compared to, like, 2 years in a long distance is totally different. But, that's why I was like, what? Why? I was questioning why she was loving me in the first place, and I was also questioning things that I was doing as a person. I mean, I was young, I was growing up, and I was making stupid mistakes. I was kind of acting very shit for a 20-year-old, 21-year-old, 22-year-old. And,
dude,
I've
been there.
Yeah. And it was things that I was already correcting in my life. So I went back and I righted the wrongs. I cut the loose ends and I did everything I was supposed to. But around this time when she was talking to me, I was trying to figure out what I wanted for me. And then once she said that, it was like, okay, now what happens with this? Because my picture was just me going down this path, however the hell it was winding. And then it became a lane for two. And I was like, okay, now how do I... And it's not that...
Include them in your
practice. It's not that I didn't love her at the time. It was just... I don't know how we're going to approach this going forward. Because at the time, I didn't want to be here anymore. Not like, woe is me. Like, life sucks. No, it was, I didn't want to be in Lubbock anymore. I didn't want to be in town. And I knew she lived here and was just getting into things that she's into now. And it was like, okay.
I got to think about what
but
she wants.
Yeah. Now it was like, I was just getting myself like back to form, so to speak, putting the pieces together. And then this happened, and I was like, I don't. And I couldn't tell her that I didn't want
to love you, Evan.
I couldn't tell her that I didn't want to be with her because part of me did and part of me didn't. But then we just kind of, I was like, okay, I'll explain why I said what I said to her in the first place. And then we'll go from there. Like you said, the communication part of it was...
Yeah, but to be devil's advocate on that, at least for women, guys don't ever know what they want. Guys don't know what they want ever.
No, they don't. Nobody does. Who does? Yeah, there is no absolutes
even for
in this
women,
world.
Like,
except death
we think
and
we
taxes.
Want something.
Death and taxes.
Yeah. But we think, like, women side, like, we think we want something, and then you're just like, oh, maybe not. Like,
oh, no, that's
like,
for everybody. You
know, yeah, it's like everybody.
Communication's important.
That was something I also learned growing out of age 23 and moving forward.
Thank God, at least one of us did.
Well, I mean, after my last relationship, so I tried to...
And wait, hold on. Am I the only one in a serious relationship currently?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Girl. Yes. Dude, I mentioned I have a Tinder profile. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, we all have Tinder. Does that count?
Oh, okay.
I don't.
Yeah.
I don't have...
No one asked you, John.
I don't... Yeah.
Shut up, John.
I don't have time or... Time.
No, I'm getting to the point where I'm finding very little time for myself.
But I've been in a couple of long relationships. One was in high school, about 3 years, but we're not really going. We're going like not before 20.
No, so, that's okay. My first serious relationship was 2 years in high school. So,
well, like my last relationship lasted probably 4 or 5 months, and I was trying to make things work with my son's mom. Because, like, her and I have had this thing for many years, and then going through the separation of her husband, and then, like, the divorce of her husband, and, like, they would separate,
it's
and
complicated.
Then... It's very complicated.
That is very much, it's complicated.
Yeah, and so she would leave him, they would separate, and who would she go to? It would be me. You know?
Oh, so you were the safety net.
Yeah, pretty much. I was either the safety net, or...
The rebound.
Rebound... Sorry. I mean that's what I started feeling, and I would try to talk to her about it, and she would be like no, but then she would always go back to him, uh-huh. And then finally she gets her divorce, all said and done with, and then we tried to really give things a chance.
Uh-huh.
Well, like you kind of experienced, she had like these insecurities, so it really battered trust. So I had trust issues with her going throughout. This several years of back and forth between him and myself.
Will they, won't they?
Yeah, and then she
it's
had trust
CW
issues
right
because
now.
Everyone, yeah. Including her ex-husband and back, would cheat on her. So it was like we never had this trust with each other,
uh-huh.
from the get-go, and it just like, it was a fiery downhill slope if it ever was on top.
It sounds like, and this was the thing I was dealing with when she dropped those words on me. It was,
why?
I was, no. It was, I'm trying to find myself, and I was fixing my problem. That was the problem. Second serious relationship, it ended terribly. And I jumped into the one with the model, and we both had things that we needed to fix before we even got to this point. Yeah. So I was, especially with Adriana, I was like, I'm doing this right. I need to fix the things that's wrong with me first, if there is such a thing. I mean, it's not like, I don't think it's necessarily
John,
fixing.
You're so perfect.
No, it's not necessarily fixing your problems as it is coming to terms with them.
Well, and it's being responsible too.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what you learn when you grow up. Yeah.
But it was, I wanted to do that, and I wanted to make sure before I told her anything that would pass that line already, I wanted to make sure I was on solid ground before
we.
I was trying to do that before we actually started building something from the foundation.
There you go.
Which is
how
important.
Many people have y'all said I love you too? Because if I count mine,
five.
I think
four.
I would go one.
My two. Mom, does she count? That's five.
No, like girlfriend
six,
relationships.
Six, my dad.
Like
okay, really,
like relationships, relationship wise.
Sexual relationships.
Yeah.
No.
Intimate relationships, significant others.
Well, I mean, like. I'm not intimate with somebody that I'm not in a serious relationship with. That's just me.
Yeah.
So, like, all the boyfriends that we were official, I've said I loved you to them. And some of them I regret.
But when you say I love you,
here's,
like,
here's
what?
The thing about mistakes is that you should never regret them, especially if it's something that's involved in your
well,
life.
Well, death of learning.
Yeah, it's something that you learn.
No
you take what happened, you take what happened, then you fix it.
Yeah, and I mean, there's some,
okay,
like,
bad. I gotta stop saying fix because it's not always that
it's
simple.
Not fixed. No, it's yeah. not.
It's well, it's understanding and negating whatever it is that it is.
Well, going back to like the easily saying I love you thing, like in my past, like when the first relationships I've like serious relationships I had, I would the guy would say it first because I'm just so protective of myself. And like when I was younger, I was just like, oh my god, everything's perfect. You know, cloud, you're on cloud nine.
The sun came up.
Yeah, you're. But that's the thing. Like you're on cloud nine, and you're like, this life is so great. He's so great. And then you kind of ignore the bad things. Mm-hmm. They're like the rain that you don't see because you're on top of the cloud.
You see the bad things, and then you try to justify
right.
them.
And then your friends and family tell you like, hey, these are some flags. And then you're just like, put those flags down. You know, and So,
Bree, yeah, you're leaving? No, you have to step out. You can step out.
Bye, Bree.
Before
and
you
leave,
haven't give
said
that
anything
give that
about
mic.
It yet?
Where is this date? Where are you going on this date?
Yeah. We need to know your location.
Well, he's meeting me at my apartment, and then we're going to dinner. So.
Whoa.
So, you're going to share your location.
You're going to track me.
Wait, hold on. Yes, we're tracking you.
Real quick. Where did you meet him?
Tinder.
There's nothing wrong with that.
No, there's not.
Where you turn your phone, my friend's on.
Yep. Okay. No, but to go back to what I was saying.
About the big three words.
Yeah, no, because I had one relationship where he said it first, and then I was like, I didn't want to feel bad, so I said it back. And then one thing, like he kind of was like, well, you said you loved me, so we're going to do this and this and this, that I wasn't comfortable with, and it turned into like, really bad really fast. And so that's why I say like saying I love you is not like a thing for me really fast, because I'd have to really know that person in and out, because I made that mistake back in the day, and like I still have problems like trusting people or guys in general, just because I always think there's going to be an alternative motive to why they're with me.
And it's a hard thing to get over.
Yeah, it is.
But based on what I've known, I mean, I haven't known you that long, but it doesn't stifle your personality. It doesn't give you a negative outlook on things.
No, and that's why, like, you know, you learn from your mistakes. Like, I totally agree with that. I mean, I hate that what had happened to me happened, but it made me more aware. It made me more careful in who I open my heart to. You know, it just made me more cautious as a person and not, like, saying I love you to the first
guy
that's like, you're pretty. Yeah. Oh my god. You know? Like
I love him.
Yeah, like and like
here's
they
40
just...
chicken nuggets.
See, I stopped doing that, and that's what I was doing.
So John, when she said I love you, when did you say it back?
Mm-hmm.
Like 2 months later.
2 months
no,
later.
No, I don't know.
You made her wait 2 months.
No.
Just kidding.
Well, like, okay, so my second somewhat long term relationship, she said it first, and I didn't say it for a while. Like, several...
That's worse.
Yeah, that is.
And, like...
I actually gave her a reason.
She would she would, you know, regularly say, I love you.
Oh, so she was trying to bait you.
Trying to get you to say it.
She definitely wanted to hear it.
I don't care how badly you want to hear it. You wait for somebody to be ready.
And... Yeah, but she wasn't, like, coaxing me or anything like that.
It sounds like she was, though. If she was playing it and...
Well, still bullshit.
And she didn't even try to talk to you as to why you didn't say it in the first place, and she kept pressing the issue. That's not... This
well,
goes back
I've,
to the
I've told her before, I was like, I don't... I, the first... After when she said it first, I didn't say it back. This this is a little bit like yours. she goes, like, I love you. And then she had, like, this kind of scared face because, like it slipped. And then I was like, thank you. And then she had like this kind of disgust face. Like, it's like, oh, say it back.
That's
like,
as bad as if you have sex with somebody and then afterwards, thank you. I'm like, what?
But then I explained
who
it to her.
Who does that?
No, see, what I'm just saying. I usually spank their ass and say good game.
Oh, then I went to explain to her. And I was like, I don't throw that word around. You know, like, so, I can't say it back.
But that's my thing. Like, I don't just say it to say it. Like, if you don't feel it, then...
I ended up saying it, like, a couple months later or something like that. But...
God, that's a long
time.
See,
I made the mistake where just
It was a long time, and then it didn't occur to me till later, than when I was telling this story to somebody, and we're just talking about, like, how long did it take you? I was like, it was probably several months. I was like, man, you were torturing that girl for several months? Like... Like why was I torturing her?
Like, it wasn't my fault. This doesn't exclude you from the. We're getting tattoos drawn right now. This doesn't exclude.
Oh, Taylor just came up to me. She's all drawn.
This doesn't exclude you from the conversation.
No, it doesn't.
When was the age, like around the time you started? I guess Valentine's Day, the allure of it just kind of started fading away. Because when you're growing up, it's like, yeah, we're in elementary school, and we had the box on the front of the desk, and everyone puts the cards in there.
That's pressure on its own. When you're a little elementary kid, and you're just like, I got to have the best Valentine's Day cards ever. And then everybody gets one except for that little bitch that always copies off of me.
Wow. There's a lot of harvest feelings there.
I didn't see that when I was five. But
wow. I started losing, because when I was younger, I used to be like, all about Valentine's Day, because I mean, I'm a giver. I like getting things for people and whatnot.
Uh-huh.
And
that's how I am.
It started really fading away. I started really paying attention to how, I mean, the rest of the nation or world would kind of treat Valentine's Day. And it just started fading away a little bit towards like my maybe freshman year of college.
Uh-huh.
But like, I was single. And for a really long time, living like that bachelor kind of life.
You're
a little
like,
bit.
Yeah, I don't care. I'm going to drink beer in the shower.
Yeah.
Wait, I can
Wait,
do
you
that
have
now.
To be single
I can
do
to
that
do
now.
That?
It's like, you have to be single to do that?
No.
I do that every weekend.
I take a bath and drink Shiner, dude. Just,
but I just really kind of started to disconnect myself. And I didn't really start thinking about how, when, or why until, well, now.
Until I asked
I was
you
like, oh, wow, I've really kind of changed since from what I used to think about Valentine's mm-hmm. to now, because I think it's so much BS. And it's just so, it puts the pressure on men targeting women.
Which is not okay in my book.
No, it's not. There's so much, like, stigma that goes around it, putting the pressure on guys.
It's like you have to do this. In order to profess your love, you need to buy something.
See, yeah. In order to participate in this holiday, you have to do something.
If a girl
like, it's not that
you
at all.
If you do that, get out.
No, like, yeah. That's unfortunately.
When did Valentine's Day lose its luster for you?
Age one.
I was born in hate of Valentine's Day.
I was born in it.
I was born in darkness.
I was born in darkness.
I mean, it was always, like, growing up kind of a fun thing where, ah, free candy! And
That's how they get you. That's how they get you.
Yeah.
It starts with that.
And to this day, I've only ever been on, like, 3 dates.
Valentine's Day?
No, just 3 dates.
Well, what's a date? What's a date to you?
No, what?
What's a date to you?
Oh, okay. Go.
Oh, well.
I mean,
I get super interested then.
Well,
been like that the whole podcast.
Yeah. So for me, a date for me would be like, I mean, there's double dates and stuff, but for me.
No. Okay, we'll go ideal date.
Ideal date?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
This is something that people have thought about before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have a Pinterest. I'm going to tell you right now, I am the classic white girl. I have a Pinterest board dedicated to date ideas. So I am the emo vegetable over here, and I do have a Pinterest. I am proud.
I do too, but I didn't know you had one of dates. I just...
Mm-hmm. I'd be the best boyfriend ever. Well, it's because it's something I, you know, kind of... It's something I'm like, oh, that'd be really cool since I've only been on 3 dates my entire life.
True.
But,
So what's your ideal date?
My ideal date is me and them spending time together being alone. Okay? I don't need to, you don't have to take me to the moon and buy a star.
Take me to the woods like 7 miles deep where no one can hear me.
Yeah,
and no
give
service.
Me a ride on your green on your little green tractor or anything. Oh no, it's just no, I just
sorry,
want it
Enrique.
To be
if it's little.
No.
No,
man,
I that
just,
hurts.
No.
It's a tractor. What are you talking about?
Jesus. No,
that's
a
euphemism.
I just want it for it to be us. Like, that awkward, you know, you're really excited, trying to figure out what to talk about kind of thing. It's horrible.
It's the thing. It's not necessarily a gathering of intel, but it's just naturally knowing somebody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I mean, like.
And spending time with him.
Yeah. And last Valentine's
Day. Sharing experiences
day,
instead of looking at your phone, whatever.
Yeah, and last Valentine's Day, which was my 3rd date ever, was with my ex-boyfriend, and we had really great chemistry, and that was great, but it was like the moment to, you know, be together, be alone, and kind of just hang out and have that alone time, and that's kind of what a date would be for me. It doesn't have to be a big old dress up. We're going to go.
It's like, let's get fancy.
But Valentine's Day as a whole, like, doesn't precede that.
Yeah, no.
To do that.
For me, a date is when it's premeditated, it's thought out. You have a time and a place set kind of a thing. And I mean, I'm the hangout kind of simple chick. Let's go play video games in our underwear, eat pizza, and drink Shiner Bock. Like, that's how I roll. But a date is premeditated, stuff like that. It's us, not me and you and then your roommate.
Not like the fancy dinner out.
And I mean,
I like a fancy dinner.
I mean,
I like getting
really
fresh
food. You know, yeah, and that's freaking cool. And I think couples should do that every now and then. It's not required all the time. Mm-hmm. Seriously, you could order pizza and we could watch a movie at my place. And that could be, you know, if we're alone, if it's premeditated and stuff. But I do think it's important for people to get out and do things. It shouldn't always be at home.
All right, so with that idea, what do...
Oh, hold up. I didn't ask you. Well, you're not asking the questions I am. What's your ideal date?
Sit your happy ass down.
This isn't your show.
Well, my ideal date...
Look, he's blushing.
I don't know. I am blushing. That's the hopeless romantic.
Ladies, he's single.
I put time and thought in things. So, I mean, like the whole premeditated thing. I get a schedule.
I think there's a difference between having things premeditated and then being meticulous about it. It's like, we need to do this at this time. And then if you're following an itinerary, then it's just kind of takes the... See, that's what I'm saying. Like, it takes the excitement out of it. It takes the spark out of it.
Well, I mean, the itinerary is like, for me, like, it's definitely surprise for them.
It's mostly just for
it's
me.
It's keeping me organized so I don't get sidetracked. But it just comes down to spending time and having like a quality interaction. Mm-hmm. But when I do dates, I try to do things that are kind of out of the ordinary, like the dinner and a movie sort of thing. Yeah. Although, I mean, I like dinner and a movie, but that's kind of something that just
cliche.
I don't know. Yeah, it's a little cliche. So I try to go out of that box. So maybe let's say I have a date and we'll go do figure painting or something like that. Something that people haven't experienced as a date.
Mm-hmm.
So like that, I mean, I don't really have like an ideal date to where it's a specific something, unless you're going to take me skydiving. That would be amazing. See, but that's that's a date to me. Like, yeah. I would take someone skydiving as a date. Fun. I mean, but it's just having fun interaction with that person.
Having real interpersonal interaction. Yeah.
But I mean,
I want to go skydiving.
Dude, maybe we can have like a crew date.
What? You're not that white to where you don't cheat death.
This person keeps their feet on the ground.
You know, they were showing, they're doing the study. Those that are afraid of heights and
are afraid of falling
are the ones that need to skydive because they get the most appreciation
not,
of
I don't
the,
like that feeling of
the whole thing.
I'm not. I love that feeling.
No. Like. No, like, you know, the rides that, like,
the stomach drop is awesome.
No, the rides where, like, it's like the thing,
the up and down action.
Yeah.
That's a different ride.
Thank you for riding my big green tractor.
No, the drop towers. That's what it is.
Yeah.
I hate those.
I've
been on those. I hate
that's
them.
Actually, like, mechanically induced. That. So,
but
I mean.
The feeling of falling. I'm just like.
What about falling in love?
If I was sitting back over there next to John Ryan, my monkey arms would reach across him and punch you in the face.
Oh man, don't threaten me with a good time.
Don't threaten me with monkey arms.
But like,
okay,
no.
Let's change it up. We gotta change this up. We're all being morbid and kind of about this. What's
okay,
the
okay,
best
okay.
gift you've received? Like, if you have received a gift from a significant other, from a lover.
But it's been like.
Okay, that doesn't take away from the fact that you still received it.
I received one.
I don't have like a special one.
I received one for Valentine's Day, and I didn't appreciate it. I don't want to say it. It's too sad.
Oh, you already started.
And you did turn the mic to you, so.
Yeah. Well,
I have no choice.
Because it's the sweetest gift I've gotten. So my very first boyfriend, the one that got me the big teddy bear thing, he got me, because my name's Kinsey, so it's a K. He got me, like, a something from James Avery. It's like a K. That's really
man. James Avery really is the best.
With diamond, like not like it was fake diamonds.
Get me out of a jam.
But like it was a necklace, a sterling silver necklace with like little diamonds in it, and it had a K. Damn. And it was for me. But I mean, it wasn't real diamonds, but no, you know.
She said it had a K. It was.
But I didn't appreciate it at the time because I was just like, hold on, like it was just like.
You were like me. I was like, wait, what?
Yeah. Well, and then I was like, he's getting like. I was at a point in the relationship where I was like, okay, we're cute, and then this is falling.
It is. It probably needs to be tightened.
Just okay. But then I was kind of getting scared because he was getting too serious, way too fast. And then I was like, well.
Oh, did like he get a ring too?
No, damn. No. This was like when I was a 17 in high school. Like,
hey, that is moving too fast too.
But anyways, I didn't appreciate it. But then like, okay, 2.5 years ago, he passed away. And now that's like my most cherished thing because he loved me. Like we were like on cloud 9 at the time. And then he kind of scared me with it. But. That's been my most cherished thing that he's ever, like, a guy from a past relationship has ever given me. And he was the first guy I've ever dated. Mm-hmm. So, like, that's, like, any other guy, I don't even remember if they got me. I'm sorry
that
if you're listening.
That means they didn't do enough, then.
Yeah, well, I mean.
That's their fault.
Yeah. I mean, one of my exes got me a knife, a pocket knife.
That's practical.
Yeah, I know. I carry it with me. But, I mean, it wasn't, like, he was just, like, here, protect yourself. I'm, like. Okay. He was a trucker as well.
Oh, okay.
But
that no one was judging you.
Okay. Yeah, okay, good. Because like every time I'm like, yeah, I dated a trucker. They're like, really? I'm like, yeah.
No, you said the gift and then the personality behind it. So then it made all the sense.
Yeah, I mean, he was sweet when he could.
He got you shot glasses.
That's a gift I would give.
Yeah, Mm-hmm. He got me a trucker hat.
I don't have that. That is like super.
I burned that though because he pissed me off. But anyways, I still have the knife. But the necklace was like not until after he passed. That's mm-hmm. the sad part. But
I kind of have two. Two what that are like really, I think they're pretty grand. So one was my like first really like long-term relationship. And she made this box that had just a bunch of stuff about us as a couple
in it.
Yeah, she had like rose petals in it. Okay, and like,
if I'd gotten something like that, I'd be like.
See, that's different than a necklace or earrings or something.
Or a trucker hat, whatever.
Yeah, a trucker hat or a freaking pocket knife.
But she had like she had pictures of us. And like when I opened it, it was like on the lid, it had the picture of us and the little hearts. And she also got these. She ordered these. Scratch offs.
Yeah,
it's like these love scratch offs things that are like this is
what
a free something for this.
Oh, okay. It was love. It was like love. Love based.
Yeah.
Scratch off, not Texas lottery scratch offs with Valentine's
branding
on
it.
I've done stuff like that, like boyfriend girlfriend coupons or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, it's like hey, you get a free work. Cool.
Yeah, I wasn't always doing stuff like that.
Yeah, it was really cool. And
it takes an extreme amount of creativity to do something like that.
So like that was that's I still have that to this day, and
so are those redeemable still or?
definitely not. And then the second one was with, I mean, my little boy's mom. Mm-hmm. When I think it was last year, and so I made her this ring that was a rose.
Oh yeah.
So like conceptually I had that like so people buy flowers and flowers will die, but this one never will. So that was kind of
the
idea.
That's kind of like the guys that put the fake rose in the bouquet of roses, and then like all the other ones die, and then
yeah, but mine's
that
made out of
way
silver.
Better. That was way better though.
I did mine in wax.
Yeah, mine's made out of silver, so
well,
get
that's
on my
how you
level.
Keep them. Sorry, the more you know.
But what she kind of did was she did like this reverse role on it. So she got with my roommates and surprised me. With
that comes in the cards.
Like this, when I walked in my house, there was like this rose petal trail with candles.
Oh my god!
And then I went into my room.
See, that's extravagant.
She cleaned, which was a thing on its own. Cause
you're like, hey, I can see the floor.
Yeah, I can see the floor plus all the petals and stuff. And then she had
let me know she cares.
The whole bed was with petals, and there's candles freaking everywhere, and there's chocolate. And then she was laying there.
Wait, with the chocolate too?
With the chocolate. Nothing.
This is generated towards people that are our age. We're not dancing around anymore.
I know, but
yeah.
I don't want to deal with it.
Okay, well, she was laying there.
But like, yeah, well, I think it was kind of like this. It was cool. It was
and what
cool.
She said was, paint me like one of the French girls.
No, she didn't really do that.
That would be a great line, though.
But yeah.
I hate getting that line.
And there was nothing that was materialistic about it, but it's a memory now, you know, and that was something that's...
the thought and the action, the time.
Yeah. And then she went back to her ex-husband after that.
Oh,
side note, did you know that flowers and stuff are genetically altered nowadays so that they don't smell? Because when they smell natural, in the natural wildlife and stuff, that's a sign of them dying.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
That's depressing.
The more you know.
I'm taking a horticulture class.
Oh, okay.
And
wow.
Kate, you are
what
Matt.
Isn't genetically modified these days?
Everything.
Love is.
Love is.
What's love got to do? Okay. Got to do.
With dates? When? I mean, this is.
Okay, so I'm
there.
Dealing with a room full of single people, except for Adriana.
Yeah, she's
She's like, ew.
She's like, yeah, whatever. I'm dumping you in a week.
No!
Do you
only if he knew.
Give me that Fitbit.
I need that back. Do you see yourself falling back in love? Not, I mean, it's not like anything you can plan. It's
these
not
loaded
like,
questions.
They're not loaded questions.
Oh, man, definitely. I mean, I believe in
you can
true
answer
love.
This because I was mostly asking them.
Oh, what?
Oh, well, I believe in true love for sure.
You believe in soulmates? Like, you're destined
I
to
definitely,
meet?
I
you're
definitely
destined
do.
To meet that one person?
I think there's, like, kindling
you're
spirits
answer this too.
And stuff with soulmates, but... And I don't know. I don't really believe in love at first sight, that kind of thing. But I do think true love is a thing, but you have to work for it.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
not something that, like you said, that Disney just happens. It's something you have to work for. I mean, that's why there's when in other countries, like people will choose your spouse for you, mm-hmm. and then in many of those relationships, they kind of learn to love each other. And then it just becomes like they love each other. You know, that's their
that kind of takes away the free will aspect of it, no?
Yeah, but I mean.
But it kind of comes. I'm just kind of going off
what
of like working
is.
Hard for it. You know, like you got to work at
but
it.
Yeah.
Working for it, I think that's important. That's something people take.
I mean, that's at
but like
an
you
extreme
said,
level.
You're
of course.
Putting them together and they're forcing to know.
Does
each
it mean?
Sometimes
it works
out,
and
though.
It doesn't mean that they're always choosing to work on it or actually. Be
I mean, that's an extreme,
I mean,
so
they
for sure.
For 50
but
years.
I mean, yeah, they could hate each other for 50 years, and one day Earl wakes up and Earl
dies.
And Earl's gonna die. Yeah, and Earl
dies. Earl's gonna die.
I mean, the only thing I'm just kind of commenting on is like, it's not just something that happens and just stays.
Yeah.
No, it's just mm-hmm. definitely gonna work at it.
I mean, there's
for
that
sure.
like initial love spark kind of a thing, but you gotta to mm-hmm. keep it. You gotta work on it. You gotta communicate. It's never always simple. It's never 50-50. It's.
I think everybody, even if they won't admit it, wants to be in love with someone,
well,
or more
yeah.
so have someone love them.
Yeah.
I mean, I hope I find the one. I think everybody does, but I do think that there's somebody out there for everybody. You know, it's just finding them and, like, realizing
like
that's who it is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I like to entertain that thought.
But, you know, like...
Why don't you?
I like to entertain it.
Oh. I thought you were trailing off. Like, I'd like to
entertain I like to entertain that thought. Doesn't mean I do every now and then.
So you mean you're
going to
crash into your true love someday, then?
Probably not.
Why not?
Not anytime soon.
Well, I know
it's
not
where
soon.
You least expect it, and then you're just like, damn it.
No, I don't know.
There's also timing, too.
Yeah.
Like, these
oh,
people
yeah.
can be a part
time
of your life at a certain time. And
you know
just
how many
kinda...
times I've heard timing is an excuse for a relationship?
How many?
A lot.
Every time?
Many times.
Every time. Many times.
Every
I mean,
time?
I don't know. I think a lot of it's still because I'm up over my first boyfriend. My first boyfriend was an absolute... was absolutely bad. It was bad news from the beginning. We dated for 4 years, and it was bad news. It was an abusive relationship. Emotionally, there was a lot. He didn't appreciate me, cheated on me multiple times, and made me feel guilty
can
for
go
it.
Kick his ass,
you can, sure. It's skinny enough, you'd probably break it in half before you'd even kick it. But no, so it was bad.
I'm not that skinny, am I?
No, you're not that skinny. So I still...
I mean, like, that he got a handful, honey.
Yeah.
And that's it. Not more than that. Just one.
God. I mean, that relationship has not changed how I feel about relationships or what my romantic aspect is or what I strive for in a relationship. It's just, it gets scary because I bond very fast with people. So
I'm guilty of that too.
Yeah, I bond really fast with people, so that gets to be an issue.
Are you defensive when it comes to new friends too? Like, does this affect other aspects of relationships?
Stop saying it right here. sometimes I just maybe it has not affected me as much as I think it has.
Mm-hmm.
But it gets to the point where I doubt myself a lot. I doubt myself all the time. It's been getting a lot better lately because I'm not stupid anymore. But when I was younger, it was a lot of like, I'm not worth it. I'm not good enough. It was my fault. It was my fault.
I was the same way with, yep.
And that's bull. I mean, the dude did everything under the sun to hurt me and break me, basically.
Well, and it's a thing to where it's like, I'm never going to find anybody else who's going to like me. Like, okay.
I said that and I'm, you know, five boyfriends later.
Well, that's like when I was younger and I got broken up with, okay, I'm a bigger person. I'm not a skinny supermodel type person. So I'm like, nobody's going to like me. I'm fat, blah, blah, blah. Because, you know, I'm bigger than an average woman. I'll say that. And a lot of guys just like, I just felt like I was not pretty enough. I was just like, nobody's going to find me again. Or nobody's going to like me like this dude is, even though this dude is a piece of shit.
Yeah.
But you stay with them because you're like, I'm not going to find anybody else. And you don't want to be alone. Because nobody wants to be alone.
It's that or the, things will get better.
Yeah. But now I'm like, I can be as picky as I want. Yeah. You know, like, swipe left, swipe right, whatever. What is the swiping? Where you don't want somebody, that, swipe left.
You think the time that we live in kind of enabled the shift of power?
Like, shift of power to...
Like, it's always the men doing this. The man does that.
Oh,
man,
yeah. Well, I think nowadays...
The man has to say
women,
sorry.
Yeah.
Women have, like...
Yeah, what the hell?
The switching of the powers. I think it's, like, women nowadays probably are making the first moves or saying, you know, what they think more than they did maybe 10 years ago when, like, Tinder wasn't a thing or online dating wasn't a thing.
I know I still kind of... I'm not afraid to make the first move, but I know I still, like, on Tinder... might hold out a little bit just to see if they'll message me. And I think a lot of that goes back to the way we were raised, our parents' mentalities on stuff, the way they were raised.
Courtsmanship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Courting. And that's another thing. You don't. Oh my God. Courting is so important. Dating. That is
elaborate.
Very important. Yeah.
It's well, I mean,
this is what we're talking about. You talk all you want.
I like it when a guy like makes the first move and stuff just because that's how I grew
it's traditional.
Up too. But then I'm a very outgoing, like, strong
eccentric,
person,
yeah, yeah.
And so like I want a guy to like, hey, I'm gonna do this, okay. Like, you have a plan? Yes, because
be
like
ready,
I've been
be ready
really,
by 7, okay.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, I don't like them to have total control, but like I want them to have like, hey,
to,
we're gonna
to have
be
some
a leader.
Sort of
yeah, be a leader. I'm totally like, yeah, because I'm a leader myself, and so I've been in relationships to where it's like I felt
type
like
A,
I was the
very
dude.
Type A.
Yeah. And I felt like I was the dude in the relationships. Yeah. Like, I felt like I was the dude in a relationship one time. And I was like, this isn't right.
Yeah.
And he was shorter than me. So I really felt like the dude. I'm just saying, like, he
does
was.
Does height have
me.
A lot to do with.
No, I mean, it doesn't matter to me, but like.
Apparently.
No, but like, how he wasn't like a very assertive guy.
Uh-huh.
And I my personality is very loud and like assertive and stuff, and so like his was like very timid and blah blah blah, but he was cute and stuff, and so then there was a point where like I could lift more than he could.
Yeah,
I and
mean,
I felt stronger than he, because I'm like, how are you gonna protect me? It's like,
I think that's a backwards way of looking at it though.
No,
I mean, y'all are
like,
all
that's
about
fine. I think like that's fine.
Because then
cause
he can go like, man,
different.
I'm gonna get my girlfriend to whoop your ass.
Yeah,
like,
I don't know.
That has happened. Oh no, that's happened with me.
Not like that. I mean, like, everybody's different and they bring certain things to the relationship. Like my last boyfriend, I'm very loud, very outgoing and stuff, and he does not do confrontation at all. At all.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a problem with our relationship because he wouldn't tell me anything. He wouldn't talk to me about things. Mm. That doesn't mean I'm going to try to change him, but I would.
No, no one should try to do that.
No, I appreciate being told what bothers you, what you don't like, or if there's something I could do to like help, like talk to me about stuff.
Yeah, I'm very communicative.
Yeah.
Or I communicate a lot. I like to have things on the table.
Yeah.
In the past relationship I was in with Jens's mom, like, she didn't.
You know,
she didn't really like to talk about things.
She kept her cards close to her chest.
No, yeah, see, for sure. Like, I would until like know, she yeah, was ready, but me. Then she'll just kind of like glimpse one card and then not the rest of it.
I'd rather know that you're mad at me and that I did something wrong so that I know what I did and I can say I'm sorry and we can talk about it versus just playing it in the dark.
Yeah.
I mean.
Because mm-hmm. I'll be like, hey, what's wrong? Like, nothing. Obviously something's wrong.
Nothing's
like,
wrong.
Nothing.
Nothing's wrong.
I hate
blah, blah, blah. And then it's that girl code again. There's something definitely wrong.
That's how I counter that now.
I'm fine.
When I know something's wrong, and I know, I know it because I can read. It's okay. You know what? You're gonna be mad about this for a long time. You're gonna say something whenever you want to, but only when you want to. I'm not gonna coax it out of you. I'm not gonna coddle you.
Yeah, because there are some times where it's like, you know, you say and nothing's then it's wrong, like the and worst, they know it is, but then you're like, I'm not just ready
time.
To.
It's like
talk
at the worst time,
it.
Like, all right, getting ready to go to work. Like, you don't.
Long sigh.
Like, yeah, you're supposed to be asleep.
Something wrong? Nothing's wrong.
If cars were like women, we'd never get anywhere.
Dang.
Well,
truth.
I'm a chick. But, no, and I mean, that's something like if somebody was like, well, what's wrong? And I'm like, nothing's wrong. Then at that point, I need to understand, don't be a bitch. Stand the fuck up and say, all right, I'm not ready to talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I don't want to just explode. Give me some time.
My thing is, she knows this. I'm going to use a basketball reference. I take time to take a step back, kind of reset the offense a little bit, and analyze the situation. Because if I immediately, and I've done this at work too, like if I immediately come unhinged and just fly off the rails and I start going off on people, and it's that's not the right way to go about
it. No, that's not the right way to do
it's not cause it.
No, but I do that, and I kind of take a step back, you know, just kind of analyze what's going on in the situation, and then
that's good.
Figure out my approach. It's like, okay, how am I going to do this without being a total dick about this?
Yeah.
And then I go in, and then that's how conversation happens.
Well, see, and you're mature, and you're older, and you're wiser versus, like, Kinsey and I in our age. Because, JR, you're, like, in the middle of that. But I know for us, at this age, nobody really knows what they want. But I still think
I didn't.
Well, yeah.
I did, and I didn't at the same time. It was mostly 60-40.
Yeah. 64.
There's always that MUD that's going to kind of be in our minds, you know,
just
because you can't tell the future. So,
would you want to? Like, would you want precognitive abilities?
I don't think so.
That would be terrible.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if
you're
going to
die
like,
in 10 years.
If I was going to
it's like,
have
would you
it,
rather
I
know how would you how you're going to die or would you rather know when you're going to die?
Neither. It really sucks and I
no,
really
No, you
got to
pick one.
I really wish all
no,
the
No, you
got to
pick one.
Oh, I do. I have to.
How?
I would
because
probably pick
win. Because
then
you could void that and be like...
No, like, that's how you're going to die. Like,
I would
you,
pick
there's
win.
There's nothing you can do.
I know, but you'd void that.
No.
Like,
no.
As long as possible.
You can't.
You
what?
Can't.
I would pick
but
win.
I'm confused.
Oh, you would want that clock hanging over your head?
I would.
I'd
because I would not
how.
Want to live in fear of whatever it is that's going to kill me.
That's true.
Because, like...
Oh, yeah, because then you can make the most of the time that you have.
Exactly. If I know when, then
I know
can
tomorrow.
Just, you know...
Like, you know what? I'm just going to quit my job. Like... I'm going to go do the things I want to do. I want to be with the people I want to be with.
Exactly.
Yeah,
but I wouldn't tell anyone.
Oh,
oh
no.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Oh, no. I'd tell my brother. But
only
he would know.
Because it might affect him with the twin thing.
No, that's not how it works.
I don't think that's how that works.
It'll be a disturbance in the forest, man.
Like,
there's
or like
a
the one with Jet Li. Remember? He had like...
Oh, yeah.
I forgot
that was a dope movie, too, by the
it's
way.
It's like a million tiny voices cried out in terror and suddenly silenced.
Oh, shit.
I hate
that's
those.
Actually good. What about you? You would know when you would die.
Well, I don't know. I don't want either of it, really.
You have to pick one.
Pick.
We were already analytical about one of them.
I would do win.
Yeah, win.
You're baking off of me.
Maybe.
Well,
I mean, versus how, you're right. Why would I want to be afraid of something?
This goes with both of them. You could find yourself at peace. It's like, you know what? I'm going to
exactly.
be on the ship, and somehow a giant whale just runs into the ship, and I die. You know what? I'm going to be at peace with that as we're sinking.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I'd rather know when so then
that
I can...
That was so graceful.
like, get my crap in order. I think I'm done. You know? Something like that.
But that's like saying being able to predict the future, tying back into that, because we went off on a tangent, and that's how we always do it anyway.
Would you want to know about that by your significant other? Not
no,
be able to tell them?
It's not like you can't plan for these things to happen. Mm. And I feel like that's what this February 14th is about. It's like trying to make this happen, trying to set something in motion. It's like it's the soapbox at the top of the hill, and nothing's going to happen until you push it down. Yep. Like, no, it shouldn't be like that. It should be the random breeze of wind knocks me down the hill.
It should be a natural thing.
Yeah.
Or not even a hill.
A mountain? Whatever.
We don't have either of those.
You just fly off the mountain.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I think that making, having one day to be a sentimental person is some I love.
Well, when you get into the mode, it's like, oh, Valentine's something, so now I gotta do something for.
Yeah.
It's like,
and people,
BS.
More people worry about it more than approach it with with bright eyes and bushy tails.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, shit. Like, I almost forgot this is happening.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think. Well, you go. For me, at least I look for somebody who's, very sensitive and sentimental because that's important to me. Because I'm sentimental and stuff like that. But that doesn't mean I'm going to expect you to buy me a horse for my birthday.
Would you want a horse?
A pony.
No, because that costs a lot of money and that's a lot of food that I don't have.
Okay, what if you didn't have to take care of it? Everybody did everything for you. You didn't have to pay a cent for it.
I would want to take care
of it. But yeah, I'd kind of want
to,
like...
Well, I mean, you get the option to, but it's not coming out of your wallet. How about that?
Oh. Well, I would take it and be like, you didn't have to, but since you did.
Well, give me that horse.
I don't know. It's my horse. It's my responsibility. So.
It would be your responsibility.
Not if everybody else is taking care of it.
No,
for me.
I mean, paying for it and everything.
Not if everybody else is paying for it.
It's still your responsibility. You can't. Someone pays for your child. Someone pays for your child, but you still have to maintain it. That's kind of the same thing. Well, no, it's different. Mm. One, animals and humans are not the same. Two, people that call their animals fur babies. Totally different than actually having a real baby.
Oh, very much.
Oh, you don't got to tell me that.
I have a real child, so yes.
Yeah.
If you had that person that did everything for you, would you feel like...
You'd be a spoiled brat.
Yeah.
I would try and do as much for them as they do for me.
Yeah.
Like...
I know, I like...
Not necessarily
like,
with
need,
gifts?
Yeah, well, I mean, with gifts, like, if they mean something, then, like, I'm going to do... I'm going to do at least something that is at equal emotionally, you know? Like, if their way is to give me a bunch of jewelry, I'm going to be like, oh, my God. My way is to maybe make things for that person. Mm-hmm. But, like, I would try and do, like, give back if, like,
it's not the,
same level of...
You spend $20 on me, I'm going to spend $20 on
no,
you.
No, it's not it's like... The... Yeah.
You got me a trucker hat? What's the equivalent? Here's this middle finger.
No lie.
Foam middle finger.
Or in my case, I burned
it. So you can see it.
I burned it. Yeah. That's my... I burned it.
I have a question on this. I mean, to everyone, if that's cool.
No, my show.
It's your show, but I have a question.
Just cause, mine.
When do you think, with dating, when do you think it's okay or when the guy should pay for it all?
No.
We're not dating, so.
Well, you're all together.
Yeah, there's a big difference between.
I think if you're
we'll
dating,
get back to your Facebook officialness later.
Yeah, no, like to pay, like
is
pay
it?
For dinners and stuff. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, like okay, so I mean, there's this thing about the guy should pay for stuff.
I don't think. Yeah.
No, when is it okay? I can already cross that out because
That's an unreal expectation, and that's not fair in my book because a relationship is.
Give
mutual.
And take?
I mean, it's never going
to
be just.
And we
about
got lucky
you.
To have.
It is not
awesome
about give and take. A relationship is not someone and I hate when people say that too. It's like, oh well, he did this one thing for me, and I sat through this football game, and now we're going to go see this movie.
No,
see,
that's
like, no,
not
that's,
how I think. It's
there
not
should be
always,
no sacrifice.
Yeah, it's not always 50-50 though. You have to. I mean, some days you're going to have to give it all, and
that's part of a relationship.
Yeah,
because I tell Adriana too. Like, she's like, "Hey, I'm gonna watch this show. Want to watch it with me?" I'm like, "No, not really. I don't." I mean, I can be I can be very abrasive about it.
Yeah,
but not like a total jerk.
But
well, no,
see, that's
jerk.
Why I think because when you get married and stuff, it's both of your income, right?
Yeah,
right.
So why should you expect a guy to buy all of your meals? Yeah. Why should you expect a guy to buy all of your meals? Or like if you guys eventually move in, why should you expect
because
him to pay for
was,
rent?
And like, not even everyone. My parents weren't even raised to think, well, my dad's kind of old fashioned. But it's not like, why should he questions it. And I think that's kind of where I get it from both of them. It's like, mm-hmm. So why should I have to do this?
Mm-hmm.
Like, where is it written down? Like, where's the stone that it's set
in? I think it's a good, you know, kind of step in courting because it's kind of like the gentleman's way to do it. But
it's
you know,
of hand.
Yeah, but you know what also is very gentlemanly to do? Open the door for a woman.
Oh my God.
Open the car door for her. Help her carry stuff.
Hey.
What about a first date?
Okay, no. What about... You see a total different side of this. A man doing that for you would kind of make you seem powerless, would it not? Or it makes it seem like you can't do anything for yourself, so
see,
I'm going to do this.
And see, you know what? That's where I think I confuse most people because, you know, my artwork is actually very feminist, very empowering mm-hmm. stuff. It's about feminine concepts.
Same.
But and I used to feel that way. Like, you don't have to, I can do whatever the f*** I want. I don't need you to open the door. But you know what? If you open a door for me, that's like, yeah, you care. You're like, go ahead. I think that's great. Now, mm-hmm. versus me 3 years ago, maybe.
See, I'm really big on that.
Yeah, let me check my imaginary.
I like to open doors, especially on dates. But I open doors for, you know,
yeah, you
anyone.
Open doors for everybody.
But I've been kind of in this weird situation before on a date where I was opening doors and she was like, it's okay, I can open. Or she said, I can close my own damn door. And I was like,
all right, date's over. You just closed the door on this date.
Well, my thing
and
is...
I didn't know what to do. I'm like, do I continue shutting this door that I was halfway shutting?
I would just
like, I can do it. I'm like,
okay.
Oh, I would have been a smart ass about like, all right, you get the next one then.
Yeah, I was like, and that goes right back to
see, but that's how
level.
We're different.
Yeah. Yes. That goes back to maturity level because, like, my ex, and I'm going to bring him up because it was the most recent relationship, but he's all about the whole gentleman thing. At least he was. And he opened the car door for me and he closed it. I was like, you know, I can do that, right? And he goes, yeah, but I'm a gentleman, so I'm going to. And so then it kind of started this whole thing where I would lean across the car and open his car door for him. So it's kind of like this ongoing joke.
Oh, yeah. I totally did that with a friend of mine.
Yeah. But it's also like that goes down to maturity of the girl you're dating. Because at that point, it's a girl. You're dating a girl.
Well, because...
Right. And there's a difference between dating a girl and dating a woman.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah.
I'm a woman.
Thank you.
I'm a woman.
Thank you for opening that and then, or I guess like me, make a joke about it.
But, yeah.
And let them keep carrying on the way that they're doing. That's great. You don't just sit here and ridicule them for it.
Yeah. Well, like, okay, so the same trucker dude that I dated, so...
Back to Truckee.
Yeah. he was very conservative, traditional guy, and so like... I'm not used to guys opening doors for me just because I don't know. I'm just gonna, and well, not even like on purpose. Like I always open my own doors.
I break the doors off.
Yeah.
And kill them.
I end up at the door first.
Well, I mean, it's just I don't know. I'm not used to that. And so when we were dating, he would like, I would just open the doors for myself. And then like, he's like, you know, can you let me open the door for you? And I was like, oh, I'm sorry. Like, I'm not used to that. And like, he would have to like beat me to the door. And like, he would, or I would just get out of the car and he would get angry with me because I wouldn't let him do these things that are considered gentlemanly. And I'm like, I'm sorry. Like, it's habit for me. But like, I know he was like trying to be a gentleman, but like, we started having arguments over it. And he was just, he started getting arguments.
He was dating a boy.
Yeah, I was.
Yeah.
And, but he was like, you never let me open the door for you. You never, blah, blah, blah. I'm like,
well, you never have a period for me, so.
No,
I don't
but
think
like,
you
it
do
was,
that for anybody.
I don't, no. But
yeah, if it, were up
it was me, weird example. Because I'm like, he's trying to be a gentleman and like all that stuff. But then he got mad at me for not letting him be a gentleman.
No, that's ignorance.
Yeah, but it was just like.
That's just someone that likes to argue.
Yeah, though there was a lot
someone
of problems.
Like, just
that's why
find
I burned the house.
I like confrontation and I like getting into arguments, but I'm not argumentative like that. I'm not looking for a reason to get into.
Yeah, and I'm
like,
a
you wore that shirt, damn it. I don't do that.
I don't egg it on, but I will finish it.
That's me. Dang, okay, Mortal Kombat.
Finish her!
Oh, what were you going to say?
Oh, what was it?
About chivalry.
About chivalry?
Yeah.
Is it dead?
Is it?
Is chivalry dead?
Is it?
I don't think so.
I still see it every now and then.
Well, I mean, like you were saying, like, I think that guy took an extreme, Truckee. chicken extreme for sure. I mean, on chivalry, I mean, I found myself very chivalrous, and because I mean, I do like opening doors, and I do like giving on dates. I like to be courty and, you know, dress nice, but I mean, that's not what it's about.
Yeah,
and it's about the time spent with each other.
No, but, like, I think it's about respect.
Yeah,
I think it's just about respect.
Yeah, and like, to me, when I'm on a date, I remove myself completely. And just
that's not how that's supposed to work.
Well, like I know, like in my mind, so I'm kind of showing
showing yourself off.
Yeah.
It's a peacock effect.
Yeah,
I'm trying to look at all these feathers. What you're we're so doing pretty. Is like, hey, we're having fun.
Yeah,
it's like it's not. It's
I don't think you should completely negate yourself though. That kind of.
But I'm having fun doing it.
I don't know. You still have to care about you. This goes for anything.
Yeah. And that's something I've learned because you and I are both very, very much into giving for the other part.
Oh, yeah. I'm
like,
I'm
if you're finding all this time and energy to spend on somebody else, when do you get it for you?
Yeah, well, when do they? Yeah. And that's something I'm
in
trying
to figure studio.
Out.
In the studio.
No, because that's for something else.
I don't know.
Like, actual time just
for
you.
Yeah, I was like, they got to give you
something for you.
Too. You can pull on a rope all you want, but if they're not pulling back, like you're just slapping it around.
Just, yeah, that is true.
It will fine.
If no one's tugging that rope, then you're just tugging your
I am really bad, but I am really bad at that. Like I'm a giver, and not really. I don't really think about myself a lot.
Too, but you can't say everybody.
Which isn't a good thing.
Oh, I learned that a long time ago.
Yeah, I did too.
But I mean, there's times I just don't like when people are talking.
My boyfriend number three.
Yeah, I've talked about this before. They would say you need to know how to sometimes be selfish, and I don't like the way that sounds. I get what they're saying, but I don't think anyone should be selfish.
No, so but you need to learn how to learn how to be selfish for yourself, not being selfish.
No, you can reward it by learning how to put yourself before others.
Yeah,
if you want to soften that blow. Well, either way, it's you being. It's you dedicating time for yourself. No matter how you word it, it should be that anyway.
And I think that's what, like, being single, that's your time to, like, do stuff for you instead of going, like, because I know people that are like, I have to find somebody
because,
you know, they have to have
somebody. Because this is
somebody.
What I have to do.
Yeah, and it's just like, if you can't be by yourself and, like, focus on yourself, how are you supposed to worry about
another exactly. That's what I was focusing on before I met Adriana. I was alone for 11 months before I actually started talking to her. And that was, like, the longest time I had ever been by myself. And I was like, okay, this seems kind of cool. Except for the second month when I was like, yeah, this kind of sucks. But my biggest fear actually is this would probably be second now that I've prioritized things. It's like having an impact would be my biggest fear. But it used to be not having anybody. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, you have family. That's different, though. Like, dying alone was, like, my biggest fear for a long time. Yeah, and it wasn't like I attached myself to somebody just to have somebody.
Just to have somebody.
No, it wasn't. That wasn't the case. It was, oh, this person has things that I like, and we're compatible, and we're similar, whatever.
Yeah. For me, ultimately, and this is another thing Terry taught me, is the, one of the...
Your Trekkie?
No. He's my mentor. one of the,
You're going to refer to him as that now?
That's exactly what it is. But my mentor, Terry, taught me that one of the greatest gifts in life is to have somebody to go with you through everything. And hopefully I get that, and I want that.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean I'm going to...
Strive to make that your first priority.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I can't. There's no reason for me to do that right now. I'm in college.
Mm-hmm.
I get in a freaking degree. I got to learn how to adult already. There's no reason
I should. I hate that word.
Yeah.
And there's a whole thing of like, okay, you're in college, but you don't know what you're going to do out. Like, you graduate, a job might take you across the country, you know. But if you date somebody here that's still going to college, you're just like, and then the whole long distance thing, and then blah, 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 blah.
Again, that goes back to the effort, that goes back to the community, that goes back into everything, all the fundamentals of relationships. Man, I should write a book about that. It should really be the fundamentals of relationships.
Because I've done long distance too with the trucker. Because he's a trucker.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know?
I thought he was an astronaut.
But, like, that long distance, like, that didn't work out because he ended up cheating on me.
That goes more about that. It says more about him than it did about you.
Yeah, but, I mean, long distance is not for about everybody. It was just a bad.
but long distance isn't for everybody. That's what I mean.
Oh, absolutely.
Because I was in that even relationship,
short
I was like...
Short distance isn't for everybody either.
And that's true. But like in that relationship, I was distance. Like the giver person. I distance was like, how are you? I would stay up because he would drive for hours because they have to be on a time mm-hmm. thing. Like I know so much about U-Haul trucks.
Yeah, but you staying up all night and sacrificing your yeah, schoolwork.
I would stay up because he would have a hard time staying up because he was driving. So I'd be
that's his damn problem.
Yeah. I know. But that's the thing. Like I was given yeah, my yeah, time yeah, yeah. and like I was... I'm a very care. Caring person. Like, if you're in my circle, you're my circle for life. You know what I mean? I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to do whatever I can to help you.
Yeah.
And he was in that circle at that time. So I was just, I was like, not sleeping because I was on his schedule yeah. instead of mine. Like, there was a lot of. Mm-mm.
I feel like that's with us now. Like, I hate that you wake up when I leave the house. And because we both used to work the morning shift. I was talking to Adriana. We both used to work the morning shift because we have the same job, kind of different places, but it became like yeah it was easy for us to work around each other because it was we both wake up at the same time, we both mm-hmm. get home at the same time. Now it's kind of opposite because she moved to night side, so now she's 3 to 11, 3 to 12 sometimes.
She moved to the dark side.
Yeah, it's different now. My side's the dark side. I'm not awake during the day. I sleep during the day and wake up at night like, oh, it's vampire time. All right. Yep. No, but it shouldn't be. And I feel bad that it's the way that it is with us, but at the same time, we make the most of it. Mm-hmm. And that's not giving up ground. No mm-hmm. one should have to sacrifice anything.
Yeah.
People are like, no, yeah. it's like, it's give and take. Like, no, it's a team. Mm-hmm. Like, everybody yeah. works together for the common goal, whether it's let's get a puppy or let's live in this house or let's move to Hawaii or whatever.
Yeah. It's a team effort.
So my team. Brother has... is now getting married.
Congratulations.
Damn
yeah,
it!
Congratulations.
I'm the best man. But I didn't think about this until now. So, his fiance,
mm-hmm.
they met in high school and she moved to Marfa. So, they haven't been in the same city since high school. And he graduated.
That could prove to be difficult. Say they end up around each other and then they find things like little quirks that they don't like about each other.
Yeah. But like they've I don't know exactly when they just kind of started dating, but I think it was 2 weekends ago is when he proposed to her.
Mm-hmm.
They met up in Midland and he proposed. It's just kind of striking me now, like they've been doing this long distance
for like
years
since they've known each other almost.
That's weird.
That
yeah.
It's hard because it's like you said, like if until you're like next, like it's on online dating too. Like,
yeah, yeah,
unless
yeah.
you're with them, you notice things like they crunch their food weird.
And
like,
yeah.
Sometimes he doesn't brush his teeth.
They talk in their sleep and it's annoying, you know, or they snore. But, like, you don't know that unless you're, like, with them for a period of time.
And I was yeah. talking to him and I was like, so when is
he's
she gonna
younger
in?
Than you, right?
Yeah, yeah, he's 22.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
He's 22?
I know, or, he's
yeah,
so 21. Attractive.
Yeah. So he's in the military. He's stationed in Fort Hood right now, and she lives in Marfa. And I was talking to him, and I was like, so when's she going to move in? She's mm-hmm. like, oh, she probably won't move in until after the wedding.
Whoa.
And I was like, what? Because, like, he also might go overseas again. Mm-hmm. So if he extends his contract at a certain time, it extends it only 8 by 18 months. So then he'll go overseas.
That's still a long time.
But he'll get to choose where he wants to go. So he can choose Italy, Germany, wherever. And I was talking to him about when he brought that up. I was like, so if you do that, they're going to get married before he ships off so he can go with her. But that'll be the first time of them living together
yeah.
in
that's
a different
crazy.
Country. This is like blowing my mind right now. I'm just like just now thinking about this.
Don Ryan's head literally just exploded.
Oh, yeah. But my
it's
ears
everywhere.
Are oozing.
Just the top of it. But I think we all have a general consensus that everyone should be treating people with respect almost all the time anyway.
Definitely.
They shouldn't just have one day to do it.
Or it's one-sided of respect.
There's
yeah.
so much. Like,
I'm really weird with living with someone, too.
Yeah. I think you should live with someone before you get married. I think. I mean,
I think
a lot of people might be against that because they're like, whoa.
I also think you should live outside of your country just to get a viewpoint on someone how somebody else lives. That's a different thing, though.
If
that's
you
a
can
different
afford
topic.
It, that
that's
yeah.
a different topic
episode.
Altogether.
No, but if you live with somebody, like, let's say they, your brother and her, like you live together and they've never lived together before.
Mm-hmm.
Or even if a normal person is like, oh, we're dating for like 5 years, we're going to live together after we get married. And then they live together and all those habits, because
Yeah, putting that on the timeline. I had a friend that was like real big on like, I need to get married by, I'm going to graduate college at this time. I'm going to have a job at this time. I'm going to get married at this time. Like, you can't do that.
You can't schedule your life.
Yeah.
I mean, you can schedule when you're going to graduate, but you can't schedule.
You can't even schedule that because that's, I mean, me and Donna, I know that.
Yeah. Curriculum changes so much.
Sometimes it doesn't work. Yeah.
You can't schedule kids. Mm-hmm. And
you can, but
not even when you're trying. Like, you don't even know.
I wasn't a scheduled kid. My mom didn't even know about me until she was 6 months pregnant playing basketball.
I didn't know Jensen was mine until he was almost 1 year old.
Fancy?
Oh, damn.
Yeah. That is a completely different story.
We'll get into that another time.
That was a wild story. I do have this weird, crazy story with living with someone, though. So, dated this girl just before I tried to get with Jensen's mom.
Mm-hmm.
And her and I were, like, best friends for a good long time. I've known her for a really long time. And so she signed a lease to be my roommate. And my parents are.
That's how you know it's real when it's on paper.
Yeah. Well, this is before we started dating.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. So she signs.
It was real before he was even real.
And she was just going to be my roommate, and we're going to be friends and whatnot. And then started hanging out, and then I asked her out, and she became my girlfriend. And some things happened. And, well, I'm just going to just kind of own this.
You broke up, and now you're still living together.
Well. It's how we broke up, and it's
you done f***ed up, dude.
I done effed up. So what happened was, something happened with Jensen's mom and I while we were dating. So I mean, just gonna bluntly say I did cheat on her, and so I've been on it, and I feel awful. I always feel awful about it.
Well, that means you're a human.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And,
if you didn't feel awful about it, then you're like a total douche.
And I told her right after it happened, and like.
Wow, you didn't even shower, huh?
No. No, sorry. It was the next day. It was actually the next day.
Fresh!
Sorry.
It was like, hey, and check it out.
Yeah. And it was an awful thing. I wish that didn't ever happen. And it was like a 10-year friendship that just went down the gutter. But
wow, that's a long time.
Hey, that's what happens, though, when you're like, that's why some people don't get together.
Yeah, sorry. I mean, like, sorry doesn't fix anything, but like, I you know, I told her.
Sorry is the first step to vindication, I think.
Yeah, like, and I told her there's no sorry that can make up for what I did, but she still ended up moving in. Like, she at any point could have said no, but she still moved in, which was a weird thing to me. So she moves in, and I'm not saying what I did wasn't. But she was just awful to me for the next 3 months.
Oh, okay. So she set you up.
So she was using
she did it on purpose. Revenge. That doesn't sound like she was taking the high road. Like, it's forgiven. She had this plan.
And it was like super. Like, she was like spiteful. She did like really childish things too. Like she
left the toilet seat up.
She would pick up these.
Wait, that's not
the
thing for guys.
Try that again one more time, please.
She left the toilet seat down.
Yeah.
Take the toilet seat.
She put cellophane on the. It was when he tried to pee. It was just all over the.
I was trying to be as cool as possible. Like, yeah, I understand. Like, I hurt you, but I'm still gonna be kind to you. And not this whole time.
Man, you're a bigger person than I am.
She would put like traffic cones behind my truck, so it takes me forever to get where I'm going in the morning to work. And then when I would leave, she would put them in the parking spot where I would park in, so I had to get out and move them.
I would have just ran them over.
Yeah, I would have too. I'd
have
been
like,
tear those things up.
Yeah, just
took the cones and put them on top of her car.
Well, I didn't.
Or
I
just would have taken the cones and thrown them away.
Or just slashed her tires.
Believe me, I thought about it. And, but I didn't do it. I was going to try to do this kill the kindness thing, and then she was supposed to, like, move out at a certain time. So I was like, I'm just going to bite my tongue, blah, 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 so it doesn't get even more ugly, because if I go that way, I'm gonna do it to win, and that's just
that's more of a me thing. Yeah
And that can get out of hand real quick, because I know myself, if I go that, I've been down that road before, and it gets really bad. But I ended up finding out that she told my mom, who's the landlord,
man, this story just has all kinds of twists.
Oh yeah, it is that she was only going to be there for 2 weeks, but she stayed for 3 months. And I didn't know that. And my mom didn't know that. So, like, she moves in June or the end of May of last year, and she stayed till August. And like August rolls around, I'm like, so I'm talking to my mom. I was like, so are you going to have you talked to Lindsay about her move out date? It's like, what do you mean? Like, move out date? She's supposed to move out in June.
No.
And so she's been staying there till August, making my life just miserable. Oh my
gosh. Is she even paying rent?
Well, like, supposedly she was paying rent.
Like, he only knew that she was staying. For
yeah, that's why I was like, was she even paying rent?
Wow, that was like, that's some Gone Girl stuff almost.
No, man. Some and, like, heinous hoe crap. And I'll just be nice to her, nice to her, nice to her. And
you sound like my friend Curtis. Like, he's like he's a gentle giant. Just.
But there was this one time where I almost just lost it. And it had to do with Jansen. So Jansen's
anything to do with him.
I would have lost it. At my house.
Your maternal instincts kicked in?
Almost. Like, if there's this one, if it went the wrong way, it would have been real bad. Lindsay is her name. So Jansen's sitting there, and he's picking his nose.
You know, things kids do.
Yeah, what 4-year olds do.
Picking his nose because
he's 3 at this time, and he's always picking his nose. And I'm watching this happen, and so Lindsay's sitting there. Lindsay's watching him intently as he's picking his nose. So he pulls his finger out, and there is a booger on his finger. And Lindsay immediately says, "Man, just wipe it on the wall." And knowing, like, he's not supposed to do that.
What?
So Jansen's, like, looking at her.
Like, what are you
doing? And then looking at the booger. And then looking at her is like, because he knows he's not supposed to do that. And once she said that, like, I was about to just rip her a new one.
You don't.
But I didn't. So, because I wanted to see what Jansen would do, because Jansen knows he's not supposed to. And he ended up.
Wait, so that means he's done this before.
Kids like, swipe boogers places. Of course. Like, I've gotten on to him.
That's what I have to look forward to when I have a child.
I've gotten on to him before, so he knows. But I stopped, and if Jansen did, I would have to get on to him. And Lindsay knew that.
And she was setting you up.
Oh man, if he she did wipe on the wall, I would have just lost my mind.
Well, that's really screwed up, because she was setting her kid up, too.
Yeah.
Mess with the...
But he didn't, and I was filled with
that's a sharp kid.
Yeah, being proud of Jansen for not doing what he was supposed to.
I would have rubbed it in, and be like, "High five, buddy!" and just looked at her while you did it.
Take it. Well, he stood there and just like looked at her, and like, and then he didn't do anything with it, and then she walked away, and he looked at me, and I was like, "You know where it goes." And so
we practiced before.
He went over to the edge of the trash can. there. And so we went on, but that, like, I was really trying to contain myself on not blowing up on
who
her
knew just, a booger could have been so
I almost did.
Relationships as grand as they are suck. Are very fragile. Much like human life.
And
much like
fragile.
Much
and
like
boogers.
Bone and tissue and boogers.
And boogers.
And boogers.
Since I have y'all here right now, I told everybody Artication is a project that I'm working on. Go ahead and tell us a little bit quickly. Tell us a little bit about what Artication is about.
For like 2 hours. Artication, we kind of got this going a couple years ago and finally being able to do this. Thank you, John.
Yes. You're very welcome. Hey, I was there. You met me at the right time.
Right place. At your house. But, we're just trying to educate not only ourselves, but the community and rising artists. There's stuff that's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And you need to invest in that knowledge. As an artist, you need to invest in yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So,
as a person also.
Yeah, as a person also.
I see this all just ties back together.
It does.
But we're also, so being here in Lubbock, Texas, there's a lot of things that happen in the art world over mm-hmm. here. So you have this Texas Tech School of Art. We're always doing stuff. And mm-hmm. we got the First Friday Art Trail over at the LUCA, which is the Lewis Hopkins
Underwood Center
of the Arts.
Like, you should know this. Well, you're pretty much trying to make Lubbock seem like deeper than what it is on the surface level.
Yeah.
And everybody knows Lubbock to be the music scene. So this is another, I guess, creative side of it.
Yeah. That nobody knows about.
There's so much perspective, mm-hmm. and we're trying to like reveal those perspectives mm-hmm. to not just the community, but I mean even other artists. So I'm trying to break apart those stigmas that are, you know, art's not just a pretty picture on the wall. There's more than that. It's a conceptual idea.
We don't all paint as much as people. They're like, oh, you're an art major? Can you paint me this? No.
No, I will not draw you as a cartoon either.
Because it's like, okay, so Taylor is a print major. John Ryan is like a sculpture jewelry minor.
Uh-huh.
And I'm a jewelry major. So it's like, and then Bree, who left earlier, she's a ceramics major.
To go on
so
her
like,
date.
Yeah, to go on her freaking date. But we're
all
different
mediums. We'll see if he's
still
here at Valentine's Day.
Yeah. Well, because when I tell people, like, I'm a jewelry major, they're like, I didn't know you could do that. And then a lot of people don't know, like, I guess from, like,
and this
history.
Goes with conditioning, because people just say, oh, art. And, yeah, it's painting. It's, yeah, painting.
Oh, painting, and you're weird.
And it's berets
like,
and
yes,
whatever.
Yes, we're weird, but
yeah.
You
I used to
things.
Wear one.
Everybody's weird.
Yeah, and, then like, Lubbock has a very, like, the art scene is growing, like, so fast.
Yeah.
So I think, like,
I've learned this since I've been around you guys.
Yeah.
There's so many things that are popping up. I mean, with, we had a show with Blanca, and they're kind of a collective that they started that
houses.
So it's not just one entity is what you're telling me. It's like it's multiple groups.
Oh, most definitely. There's there's
it's
many
not just
groups.
A school of art.
Yeah. Like there's School of Music. That's, you know, the school of theater.
Oh, I just
and,
meant
like
art stuff that's going on. It's not just
no, but
of
like
art.
That's under the umbrella.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It extends outside of these walls that we're in.
Right, right, right.
I think that's what kind of pushed me to be a part of it. Because when you were, you pretty much sold me on it. It was like, hey, this is stuff that I believe in. And this, it's part of the reason why I backed you up on this is because I believe in that too. It's like, Lubbock is bigger than it is. And this just sounds like a cool opportunity to inform people. And it's something that you are all very dedicated with. And that's why I wanted to help with it.
Well, and so, it's also like to educate people like us, our experiences being art students, because there's also like an assumption of being art students. What are you going to do with that? Like, oh.
To let them know the struggle is real.
Well, yeah. Like,
and they don't have to go through it alone.
Yeah, there's a difference between being a starving artist.
It's also not
easy.
World,
being an artist that's in an exhibition and being an artist in the college aspect.
Mm-hmm.
Just well, I'm glad shine light on this.
I'm glad I got to put this together, and I'm glad I got to help you.
Yeah!
Oh, yeah.
I mean, not that it's over. I mean, we're just barely
grateful.
Getting started. We got all
like,
kinds
oh,
of things
wow,
to do.
Four episodes
in,
we'll pick it up.
And we're done. Let's pack it up. Hey, thanks for being on the show with me, guys.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
it was
fantastic.
It was fun.
Hopefully, y'all got to stray out from the normal content y'all
I got
talk
to
about.
Swear
oh,
out.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah, it's Taylor.
I mean, you can on the other one.
Taylor's a
sailor.
Taylor's
Taylor.
Taylor's a
either way.
it rhymes.
Thank you. You are not the first person to figure that out. But anyways, I will no longer be answering questions about Valentine's Day.
I know.
At least not for another year, maybe.
Oh, God.
I'll ask you about Columbus
Single
Day.
Single Awareness Day, as it also is.
Oh,
sad.
Yeah, Singles Awareness Day.
It spells out sad. Do you know that?
I don't give a...
Single Awareness Day? Sad.
Sad.
Go out with your friends, because that's what we're doing.
Yeah. No,
yeah, hey.
This, out, so.
Yeah. I mean, if you're not with somebody that's... sexually in a sexual relationship, you can go out with your friends at least.
I was like, you don't even need to.
You don't have to be.
Unless you do
somebody.
That with him too.
Yeah,
because you know, Brian
brought up. She's like, I don't have a date for Valentine's Day again. I was like, what you talking about? She goes, I don't have a date.
Have
so sad. I was like, excuse me, what are you thinking about? Hello.
The squad.
I'm sitting right out. I was like, yeah, the squad. So it's gonna be Nicole, Kinsey, Brie, and I, and we're gonna. So far, we've talked about going on a picnic together.
Heck yeah.
Like just being damn
all the cliches.
Cute.
And buy like here's a box of chocolates
yeah,
and here's a dozen
no,
roses.
Damn
and
cute.
And
I'll be there. I'll
here's
be there.
Here's a teddy bear.
Yeah, I already bought them Valentine's Day cards and stuff and like a little some
oh
candy. Yeah,
setting
so,
the bar.
No, so we're being cute. It's great.
All the cliches that never happened to
yeah,
us
and all the
are
cliches
happening.
That you and I really don't give.
Yep,
about. Yeah.
It's happening.
It's happening.
I'm gonna go to see John Wick by myself.
We saw that Saturday morning. It was awesome.
Is it awesome? I love the first one.
It's amazing.
One.
Oh, this one just blows it out of the water. Artication again. Thanks for joining me
yeah,
with
thanks
this.
For
thanks
having
for giving me your 2 cents on this.
Oh, Jesus.
It was more like $50. But it's okay.
It was like $1 million worth.
Yeah.
$57.
Hey, thanks for joining us. And remember to join us on, you know, every week we always push this thing out. iTunes, Google Play Music, SoundCloud, YouTube. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at SunFunPodcast. Make sure you get those likes and subscribes. We really appreciate it. And if you leave a review for us in the iTunes store, we would greatly appreciate that. Got something big coming soon, and I'll let you know on this Facebook. Have a great week.
Woo! Bye. Yay!